he gets taken out, and a good check by Drew Doughty, who goes low on Tkachuk. And this is the first of Doughty and Tkachuk of any significance we've seen, and it's a giant dogpile. These guys have been pretty quiet tonight in terms of playing against each other, but it erupts here in the third period in a game that's out of reach. And it all started with that hit by Doughty on Tkachuk.
Well, wait till you see Mark Giordano come in from the blue line. And Drew Doughty recognizes it's Matthew Tkachuk coming up the left side, and he just times this hit perfectly. And look at the smile on his face. I mean, he could feel this moment happening the entire way up the neutral zone. He knew exactly who it was.
Fullback running the short yardage offense there, going up over top into the end zone. And then Tkachuk had Doughty pinned. And we just mentioned a few minutes ago, Cassie, it's been pretty quiet between these guys tonight. So much for that.
As the Devils work the puck into the Vancouver zone. Oh, Edler, there's going to be a penalty here as he forgot about the puck and went after Coleman, who hit his head on the ice after Edler kind of kicked his feet out from under him, and the Devils respond en masse, trying to get at Alex Edler after what they perceive to be a dirty play. Sutter's dropped the gloves here with Mueller. Down they go.
Blake Coleman talking with Alex Edler. Well, here's the little chip in, and Coleman's going shorthanded after it.
Shoulder to the face. The last two seasons, Ryan Getzlaf. Whoa, here's off the break. The Sabres on a breakaway. Oh, and Olofsson hit hard in the corner. A penalty coming up to the Ducks. Right off the faceoff, they sprung Olofsson. And as he went to the corner looking for his Karam, he got hit hard. Now Grant pulling a player out of the pile, and things getting a little dicey.
And there's the opportunity that goes off the stick of Olofsson. And you know what? I mean, Rowney's going to get a penalty for this. But watch what Olofsson does. As he's about to accept the hit, watch how he ducks down. I mean, he puts himself in a real vulnerable position by ducking down on this play. He's in that area that's, you know, that problem zone. You're about 3 feet away from the boards. And boy, when you get hit and you're that distance away from the boards, nothing good happens. Brownie's going to get the original call, and then we'll see what happens after that.
The Blues a little bit on their heels right here. The LA Kings are doing a great job of supporting pucks and putting them on net. Oh man, did Binnington just got little shoulder check right there as he was going for a skate. And here we go.
Clifford then came over and gave him a little cross check, and that draws a huge crowd.
I look quickly over to the right where Jonathan Quick is in his crease, but Binnington didn't continue this one on. He let his teammates take care of it. He went back to the crease, and the whistle had gone. Whoop! And Clifford goes shoulder to chest right into Binnington. Binnington just kind of...
It's indeed center pass that's knocked away by Sean Monahan. That's defensively a hard hit on Shillington, pushed into the glass as the horn sounds to end the second period. Both arms are up. There's a penalty on the play against Winnipeg.
And they're just making sure that Shillington's okay as Riddick's down on his defenseman in the bottom of that pile who took the initial hit. It hasn't been an overly physical game. We saw a couple of pushing and shoving the previous whistle between Wheeler and Tkachuk, but this one off of the hit, a couple of penalties will be assessed. The question is just how many.
So
So you see Shillington back to his knees, being attended to by the medical staff.
You know, and this is one, if the Jets end up being down one or two, I'm sure for Paul Maurice, you're going, the period's over. There's no reason to get in and get something going at that point, and it's one of those dangerous plays down low. Seconds are off, and yeah, you can see Lowry got Shillington right on the numbers with, what, 2 seconds left? And his head, oh, it's the head to the glass, that the reaction of Riddick as he's watching that one, and then pops right on top.
8 seconds apart for the Flames. And they open up the 4-1 lead. With a shot that goes wide, puck comes back to Green. Larkin behind the net, looking in front. Riddick got the stick out to block the pass. And Helm gets involved with some rough stuff as he took down a Flame. That was Lindholm right in front of the Calgary net. And Lindholm is down in some discomfort. And all that was going on away from the play, Kelly.
Yeah,
I'm not sure what started it all.
Helm went down first, and then he got up and went after Lindholm, I believe. Let's see how he goes down. It's in the slot. There's a collision. Oh, there's an elbow from Lindholm to Helm, and now Helm's going to go after him.
Oh, slash in the back of the leg. So reaction to the Lindholm hit.
Right.
And Lindholm felt that one as he makes his way off the ice. So Helm gets a 5-minute major and a game misconduct for that slash.